Hey, this is Terry, and in this video I want to discuss the USB-A input found on all primary Prisma models represented here by an NP5 Prisma. When we designed the Prisma network player platform, we prioritized a NAS drive, a local area network connected hard drive, that would be composed of a self-powered housing into which you would put two or more hard drives, and then those drives would be in a RAID configuration, meaning they would provide automatic backup of any of the files on one of the drives onto another drive. This means that if one of those drives failed, you'd be able to replace the drive and the files that was on it from those that were saved in this configured hard drive. This gives us a couple of advantages which caused us to prioritize this type of storage and playback means in that it provides the best audio performance. Ethernet cable connected from the drive to your network, to your switch, to your router, whatever it might be, and then with a similar Ethernet connection to your Prisma product, although you can use Wi-Fi, we recommend Ethernet, you will get the best audio performance. Then there's control and connectivity. If you download a media management software like the free Minim server we recommend, much of the hard work of organizing your files is taken care of by that software. It allows you to not only better search and find and organize your files, but it also allows you to create playlists, play queues, have metadata more readily visible, cover art, etc., depending upon how you put it on the drive. But nonetheless, it provides this level of connectivity and control that we think is superior. And so you combine that with the audio performance, and this is our recommendation. To the extent that we simply have not provided that level of control, connectivity, and features at the USB-A input. Now, there are a couple of reasons for this, why we have decontented the USB-A input, which, by the way, was originally a service port, meaning it would allow for software update if you didn't have Ethernet or internet connection. Now, when we saw that port, we realized, well, we could provide a convenience feature, not for critical listening, but for casual listening, of files that you might have just on a thumb drive, on a portable drive that you want to plug in and play. And we understood the efficacy of this because we find this to be a good way of bringing demo files with us to dealer and trade show events. We don't have to bring a large drive with lots of files we have to try to sort through to try to find what we want. We have a limited curated list of really great demo cuts, and then we can plug it into that USB-A input without any trouble and be able to get credible playback. However, one of the things that we make sure we do is always put a noise reduction device in between the network player itself, the Prisma player, and the thumb drive with the media stored on it. And that is usually an AudioQuest jitterbug, although iFi and other manufacturers make them. They allow for that USB input to perform at a level that it otherwise would not be able to do. Now, the one thing that the jitterbug doesn't do, and the one thing that really, really can't control, is that the power from the USB-A input not only causes noise, but also may not be sufficient to drive some of the larger portable drives you might have sufficiently. All the power for those drives comes from that port, unlike the NAS, which has its own independent power supply. And power supply is key, is the foundation for the performance of any product. And so you're limiting then the power that the drive gets, and therefore maybe limiting its capacity, not only for connectivity and control, but even maybe limiting its audio performance as a result. So there is the notion then that when you're using that, use some noise canceling device like that jitterbug that I mentioned to make sure that you get the best possible performance. And then you're going to have to organize your files on the drive in a way that will require some manual effort on your part. You'll need to put the USB drive, connect it to your computer, and then create essentially your own file folder directory. Now, in the Prisma app, we have a 50 folder or file view limit. What this means is that at any one time, you can only see 50 folders or 50 files. Now, if you organize those files and folders correctly, you can see everything. It just means you have to take a little care when you're putting it all together. So what that means is we recommend that you simply create a folder for every letter of your alphabet. Then within that folder, in each of those folders, you create a folder for an artist that name starts with that particular letter of the alphabet. So, for example, you might have Prince. So you would go to the P folder, open up the P folder. In the P folder would be a Prince folder. In that Prince folder would be up to 50 Prince music files. If you needed more than 50, say, in your prints, you're an avid prints fan, you would simply add an additional prints folder in the P folder, so you'd probably have prints 1, prints 2, and be able to find, access, and playback every file on that drive. And so, again, it takes a little bit of work, and again, you can't create playlists, you can't do play cues, you might have cover art, maybe, it depends upon how you put it up on the drive, and metadata, maybe, depending upon how you put it up on the drive. But nonetheless, you'll still be able to play it and get good results. We have evidence of this from all the demos we've done at trade shows and dealer events where people have commented on just how good it sounds. Now, the final and maybe cautionary tale to provide you is that even if you're going to do this, even with the fact that we couldn't have anticipated, even though we should have, that you can get 2 terabytes of storage for 100 euros, which blows my mind given how long I've been working with portable drives, we understand how you might want to use it, but would still suggest that at the very least, make sure you're backing up those drives every time you make a change. Make sure that you have at least 2 drives to set it up kind of like that RAID configured NAS drive, backing it up all the time. But regrettably, if you're anything like me, you will forget. And then if your drive fails, you will have possibly a lot of lost files that may be hard for you to get back. Because one of the things that I have found in my experience as a film teacher and film producer of documentary films is that you never rely on a portable drive to store valuable assets. You just don't. And so what we would do, say recording a video like this, we'd be recording it on an SD card inside the camera as I'm doing here, and you would take the SD card out at the end of a shooting day on location particularly, and you would take that card and you would download the contents of it to 2, not 1, but 2 portable drives, giving us redundant backup storage as you went along during your filming day. And then when you were done with your location shooting, no matter how many days it was, you would get back to your offices, my producer's office, my editor's office, and we would download those drives. We'd separate them and download them onto our own NAS drives connected to our computers, with the idea then that once we got them on our RAID configured NAS drives, we would have the confidence that those assets, those valuable assets we could not get back, would be preserved. Now, we'd still keep the portable drives just as kind of an emergency backup, but because they fail, even that we can't rely on, which is why we had to download them to these hard drives. And this is the reason for this pile of boxes here. Inside these boxes are little thumb drives that we bought. We put our primer logo on with the idea that we'd hand these out with brochures, with review reprints, documents like that, and maybe even some music files. Problem is, I can't. The problem is that 50% of these drives have failed. And therefore, even for putting out documents, I can't rely on them for that. So, for those of you here that are using a USB-A inputted portable drive, please consider setting up a NAS. Things will sound better. You'll have better confidence that you'll have those files when you need them. And it simply will provide a better listening experience. So I think I've covered just about everything. If not, and you have any additional questions, please feel free to go to our website, look at the FAQs, you might find the answer to your question right there, or submit a help request where we and the rest of the team here will do our best to respond to any questions as quickly as we can. And additionally, if you like this kind of stuff, click a like, and maybe even follow so that you're notified whenever we do more of these videos, which we very much intend to do. Thanks.